Hello and welcome to our Diatom training video. In this part of the video, we are going to demonstrate sampling of benthic diatoms in rivers following the instructions of the European standard. The second part of the video will be all about processing the collected material in the laboratory. The European standard covers all aspects of diatom sampling in flowing waters relevant to ecological status assessment using benthic diatoms. This video aims to give practical examples and guidance for the methods described by the standard. Following these sampling instructions will result in samples suitable for quantifying relative numbers of benthic diatom taxa present and can serve for calculation of diatom water quality indices. In general, diatoms are growing on most submerged surfaces and may be detected by feel or seen as a thin golden-brown film covering the substrate. Thickness and structure of the diatom biofilm may vary across the river vertically, horizontally, and temporally, depending upon many chemical, physical, and biological variables. For ecological status assessment, it is therefore crucial to ensure that the sampled biofilm communities are in stable conditions and the disturbance impact is reduced to a minimum. The main objective of the European standard is to collect benthic diatoms from submerged hard substrates, preferably stones, the so-called epilithon, to produce a representative collection of the diatom assemblage indicative of water quality. The diatom biofilm can be sampled from pebbles, cobbles, and small boulders, with cobbles being the preferred substrate since they are easy to handle and more stable in changing hydraulic conditions. Stones covered with a layer of sediment or attached filamentous green algae should be avoided if possible. When stones are not available, alternative substrates such as macrophytes or man-made objects, for example bricks or concrete pieces, can be sampled. For choosing an appropriate sampling site, several criteria should be fulfilled. The river segment should be about 10 meters long, but also longer stretches may be appropriate. Hard substrate, preferably cobbles, is available, and unshaded riffle sections with maximum sunlight are present. Prior to sampling, a detailed description of the site indicating location, coordinates, widths, depths, substratum type, percent cover of macrophytes, percent of shading, and other specific details depending on the project and monitoring activities is required. A photographic record of the sampling site is also important. This information serves later on for data interpretation and to help other researchers locate the site. The basic sampling equipment for collecting diatoms includes a stiff toothbrush to remove the biofilm from the substrate, a white plastic tray to collect the biofilm, a sampling container, a wash bottle, a permanent marker, and an aquascope. The aquascope, a box, bucket, or tube with glass bottom, is useful for finding suitable substrate and evaluate the state of algal biofilm without necessarily lifting the substrate from the water. Samples should be collected from riffles well exposed to the sunlight and ideally from the main river channel to ensure that the sample substrate was submerged for long enough time and the diatom assemblages are in equilibrium with the environment. Zones of very slow current and especially lentic areas should be avoided as these allow to build up loosely attached diatoms, silt and other debris. Also, substrate from the banks or close to the banks and from heavy shaded areas should be avoided. The objective is to collect epilithic diatoms from stones that are not moved in normal hydrological conditions. A minimum of 5 cobbles or bigger stones from different locations within the sampling site are sampled. The stones should be selected as randomly as possible and have an obvious diatom film. A diatom biofilm can be identified as a golden brown colored layer on the substrate, or if not visible, by feel as a slimy or slippery surface. When cobbles or bigger stones are not available, a minimum of 10 pebbles can also be sampled instead. The diatom biofilm can be removed from the substrate by using a toothbrush or a knife. The toothbrush should be carefully washed in clean river water and rubbed on a clean surface before and after each sampling to minimize any diatom contamination from previous samples. Brush the upper surface of the substrate vigorously to remove the diatom film, rinsing the toothbrush periodically in the water to transfer the diatoms. An area of approximately 10 square centimeters or more should be carefully brushed. Only the upper side of stones exposed to flowing water should be scrubbed to avoid contamination with sediment. If filamentous algae cover more than 75% of the substrate, diatoms have to be collected from the algal cover and the remaining surface of the substrate by scrubbing off the biofilm. The obtained brown and turbid diatom suspension is then transferred to the sampling container. The sampling container should be labeled with details relevant for identifying the sample and is transferred to the laboratory in a cool, dark place, preferably a cool box. If samples are brought to the laboratory within 24 hours and these precautions are followed, it is not necessary to add preservatives in the field. If preservatives are necessary, they should be added immediately after sampling. Buffered formaldehyde or ethanol is suitable for long-term storage and Lugol's iodine for short-term storage. Alternatively, samples can be also preserved by deep freezing. Sampled rivers are not always ideal, like the one we just demonstrated. Sometimes, especially in lowland rivers, hard substrate is not available and macrophytes are used as an alternative substrate. In general, submerged macrophytes are preferred over emergent ones, and the sampled macrophytes or the sampled parts of the plant should be permanently submerged and not contaminated with sediment. If possible, sample the same species or similar morphological type of macrophyte and make a note from which macrophyte the sample is taken. The sampling procedure depends mainly on the type of macrophyte which is available. The entire plant or just healthy parts of the plant with a distinct brownish diatom layer are taken using a knife or scissors. Be careful to not include parts which are covered with sediment. At least 5 healthy plant replicates, such as stems, leaves, or other plant parts, should be selected from an area with distinct flow. Place assembled macrophytes in a white tray with stream water and move or squeeze the macrophytes to obtain a brownish diatom suspension, which is transferred to the sampling container. Alternatively, you can put the sampled macrophytes in a plastic bag or container and obtain the diatom suspension by thorough shaking. Also, filamentous macroalgae can be used as diatom substrate and gently squeezed to obtain the diatom suspension. For sampling of emergent macrophytes, only permanently submerged plant parts, which are not influenced by water level fluctuation and not contaminated with sediment, are used. To collect diatoms from emergent macrophytes, cut the stems at water level and put a plastic sampling bottle or glass jar upside down on the underwater stem. Cut off the stems below the mouth of the bottle and turn the bottle with the stems upside down. This method reduces the risk of dislodging the attached diatoms from the plant. If the diatom film is not delicate, it is also possible to just cut 5 to 6 stems and transfer these directly to a sampling container. Brush off the diatom biofilm from the stems or shake the sampling container to obtain the diatom suspension. Sampling large rivers is challenging, as these are not wadeable and hard substrate from the main river channel is not accessible. Hard substrates can only be sampled from the banks, but all other microhabitat conditions must be fulfilled. In large rivers, the epilithon should be sampled near the banks in areas of accelerated flow. Substrate from greater depths than 1 meter should be avoided, since the euphotic zone with effective light penetration may not extend to the riverbed. In principle, try to stay away at least 1 meter from the shoreline. Hard substrate should be selected and collected from a variety of locations, if possible along the banks. Shaded areas should be avoided and the substrate must be submerged for long enough in stable conditions. As in wadeable rivers, preferably a minimum of 5 cobbles should be sampled. Alternatively, 5 small boulders or 10 pebbles can also be sampled. Collect the diatom suspension and transfer the field sample to the laboratory. For processing of the collected material in the laboratory, please watch the second part of our training video. Thank you.